EPH 6:12 For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
When you become a believer, the bad news is you are immediately thrown into the war zone. The Bible says we fight a war not against flesh and blood, but against the principalities of this world. But God in his goodness did not lead us into this war defenseless. He has given us the weapons of the Holy Spirit, the Word of God, which is the Bible, as well as prayer. And out of these three things, prayer is where we play the biggest role. Therefore, it does not surprise us that when the enemy attempts to disarm us, he attacks our prayer life by keeping us busy, by making us lazy, by making us feel guilty and frustrated so much that we even avoid to pray to our God. But listen to the Apostle Paul remind us to take our weapon up in Philippians chapter 4 from verse 6. The Bible says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." It is this peace that is our victory over the dominion of darkness. So pray without ceasing, loved one. Pray about your struggles. Pray about your needs. Pray for others. Pray for the fruits of the Spirit to grow in you. Pray from noonday to sunset. Pray in the morning and pray in the night, because that is your weapon against the attempts of the enemy to snatch salvation out of your hands. Don't sleep on prayer. It is power.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. Perfected Faces, done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God, contrary to the way it explained today, that I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you, there's a plan for you, there's a purpose for you, there's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts zinga with zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakala zizohole. So that is why it's very important to stick on to the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says, come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meanings from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. Because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus view, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Dark. It shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching it.